In this video, we'll get the engine bolted into the Goblin frame. If you're building a manual car, move the clutch line out of the way and zip tie it to the upper fuel tank rail. Wrap the wire harness around the end of the fuel tank and up over the fuel tank rail. Place the engine and transmission behind the chassis. Put the positive cable and brake vacuum line on the ground in front of the engine. Lift the rear of the chassis up over the engine and lower it down onto the engine and transmission mounts. Install one of the donor seat mount bolts into the engine mount. Manual powertrains will use the rearmost hole of the mount plate. Automatic donors will use the next hole forward. Move the driver's side of the powertrain until the transmission is in line with the mount plate. The SSF35 transmission will use one seat mount bolt and two of the donor engine mount bolts along with two spacers from the K21E baggie. The base F23 transmission will use three seat mount bolts and no spacers. Automatic transmissions will use all three engine mount bolts and three spacers from the K21D baggie. Use a 15mm socket to tighten the bolts to 37 foot-pounds. Install two more seat mount bolts on the passenger side. Use a 15mm socket to tighten the bolts to 37 foot-pounds. Place your battery in the battery box to get a little more weight on the front of the car. Use a jack to raise the rear of the chassis back onto the jack stands. Place the jack stands within a couple of inches of the ends of the frame rails. The weight of the powertrain can make the chassis tip over if the jack stands are too far forward.